I'm Natasha Lubchenco. Welcome to Money Wisdom, sponsored by Johnson Vernetti. We're educating you about smart ways to manage your money. And joining us is Eric Hogarth, certified financial planner and Johnson Vernetti partner. Eric, great to see you again.
You too, Natasha. Thank you.
All right, so today we're talking about Social Security. Understanding your benefits is important as you approach retirement, but with all the rules and formulas, it can be a challenge. And you say there are actually a lot of myths surrounding this topic?
There's a lot of different ways to trigger your Social Security. There's things that used to be available that aren't available any longer that sound very similar to something that is still available. So it's a big decision, we all know that, but there's a lot of different ways to draw it. And the goal, of course, is to make sure that you and your family get as much as possible out of this money that you've been saving into for a very, very long time.
Right, and it's important to understand all that goes into this, all the myths. So we have four myths today that we're going to debunk. Number one is you must claim your Social Security benefit at age 62.
Not true. So 62 is the earliest you can trigger your benefit under normal circumstances. So when I say that is if you are a widow, a widower, you can draw it earlier. If you are a parent who's older with a younger child, you can draw it earlier. But for most people, 62 is the earliest you want to draw it. Now, the reason people don't draw it at 62 is if you wait till 63, your benefit gets bigger, right? By a certain percentage, depending upon when you were born. So you get more money, but you get it for one less year. So that gets into, well, when should we be drawing it? So 62 is the earliest, not when you have to draw it.
Okay, good to know. And number two, a myth, is you will not get all the money back you put into the program.
Also most likely not true, I hope, because the only way that one's really true is if you don't live that long. You know, that's the gamble as you talk about Social Security is, well, the longer we wait to draw it, the more we're gonna get, the shorter we're gonna get it for. And some of you, as you approach this, have done the math, and you should do the math. Well, if we don't take it at 62, and we wait till 66, which maybe is your full retirement age, how long do you have to live to make up the money that you did not get between 62 and 66? And it's give or take around 78 to 80 years old. But if you live a long time drawing your Social Security, you very might well get back a lot more than you paid into it. It's all relative to how long you're drawing that benefit for.
Okay, now what about this one? Your benefits are based on only wages you earned before 65.
Also not true. Look at our myths. They're based on your 35 highest earning years. They do not have to be consecutive 35 years. They do not have to occur before age 65. So if you work past 65, those years are getting credited if they're big enough to get credited, if they're in the top 35. That's a question people have kind of related is, well, if I stop working at 62 and I don't draw till 66, is the benefit amount that I'm looking at on my statement going to be way less? No, but it's going to be impacted by that.
All right, Eric, and one final myth that we're gonna need you to clear up for us. You can claim early and then get a bump up when you reach full retirement age.
All right, so this is tricky. So, something that they did away with, and we don't have 15 minutes to go through this, but something they did away with is the ability to file and suspend your Social Security benefit. You can no longer do that. What you can still do is draw a spousal benefit off of your spouse's benefit if they are drawing their benefit, which would then allow you to switch to your own benefit at some point in the future in a certain circumstance. Super confusing answer, Eric, but you can draw a spousal and get more in the future. It's also important to note that if there's two of you and one of you dies, the larger Social Security remains. So that's gonna impact when you're gonna draw that benefit, because if you have the larger Social Security, that benefit's gonna last for two of you. So you want that number to be as big as possible.
Great, this is a great start. You know, it's important to debunk these myths. You want people to have clarity when dealing with Social Security. We all have to deal with it one day. And now I know you have a special offer for us today. Can you tell me about that?
Yeah, it's a short book on Social Security. Like all of our things, you can get it by going to www.moneywisdomtv.com. It's free, we'll get it to you. And it's nice because it's concise. Like a lot of the stuff that we use, like I'm not a fan of 100-page articles to give you one bit of advice. So it's just these quick bullet points, you know, what about this, what about this, what about this? It's very unique to you and your personal situation when you should draw Social Security, but don't make a mistake with it. So get some feedback on it. This article is a great place to start. Moneywisdomtv.com. We'll get it to you free. It's a good thing to read. I hope you do.
I love it. That is a great offer. Thank you, Eric Hogarth from Johnson Brunetti. Again, if you at home would like to learn more, go to moneywisdomtv.com.